Marines recently showcased some experimental technology they're working on to assist the Corps' new redesign of its force for a new mission. And I'm not talking about better ways to get Copenhagen to the field. Over the past few years, Marines have taken big steps restructuring infantry units, both large and small. They've also shed legacy systems such as tanks in favor of a smaller footprint. But to have small units, such as platoons or even squads, running and gunning on far-flung islands, they'll need tech to make it happen. And though the big media splash comes with weapons from rifles to planes to ships, the niche-level work that Marines are doing means gritty details such as keeping small units alive and supplied that mean maybe more than just ever before. Jarheads with 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force recently finished off a year-long experiment with the Office of Naval Research on just that goal. Marines are looking at the following areas. Experimental logistics, think 3D printing and new fuel sources. Signature management, think both real and virtual camouflage. Hiding in plain sight under canopy, but also masking or spoofing digital signatures from communications to cyber to space-based assets. And of course, command and control, talking, sending data, and managing disparate units across vast stretches of the theater such as the Pacific. One example Marine officials shared took members of the distribution platoon with Combat Logistics Battalion 8 and had them use Expeditionary Modular Autonomous Vehicle, or the EMAV, an unmanned quadcopter, and a multipurpose expeditionary platform, an autonomous forklift basically, as part of convoy operations and standalone resupply. Sounds great to me. I don't miss unloading pallets of containers or driving broke down Humvees around the woods to drop off water and chow. The tech they're using enables other tactics or approaches such as fueling the fight. Rather than a helicopter, one big, usually manned target for enemy forces, the experimenters are using multiple smaller quadcopter drones to resupply units in bits and pieces. That way, if one of those quadcopters goes down, the rest of the flow of drones can finish that resupply. And most important of all, no Marine is lost when that replacement drone meets its fiery end. Military Times saw early experiments with this hive mind drone concept a few years ago at Quantico. That hive mind idea came from a Marine Reservist Logistics Officer who'd been inspired by the then new work on drone delivery by Amazon. The recent ONR experiments tested brand new equipment in specific settings. The Corps has also run a series of standard exercises known as Island Marauder. Those Island Marauder exercises conduct typical insertion, attack, and extraction in the Pacific theater, basically what infantry Marines always do. But Marines have added in not yet fielded tech or recently fielded tech to see how that gear might help Marines on current and future missions. In last year's iteration of Island Marauder, they added the Network on the Move light utility vehicle. It's a way for as few as 2 Marines to jump on a small all-terrain vehicle in an austere site and then send and receive encrypted data or communications as the mission unfolds. So you can see it's all about getting lighter, faster, and putting more deadly tools in the hands of squad-level leathernecks. Follow us as we track all things lighter and faster and deadlier, think Marines, here at Military Times. This has been Todd South.